Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Yesterday I went to the movie theaters and I watched a live remake of Aladdin and I was kind of excited about it, but before we start the video you should know that I'm not the biggest fan of the live action remakes. I love Disney in its full glory when they make the animated movies, but I think they do always an amazing job on the live action remakes, but I'm not the biggest fan. But we'll talk about that later. Second thing I want to say is that these are all my own opinions. You might think the same way about it, you might have other opinions, that's all fine. So let's dive into this video and see what my thoughts are about the live action remake. Okay, when we went to the movie theaters last night, we decided to see this movie in 4DX, which means that you are sitting in chairs that are constantly moving, chairs that give like air puffs behind you, you can smell stuff, there's extra wind, when there's like a water scene, there's like, you actually feel the water, the splashing of the water, there's also extra lighting on the sides, for when there's like a lightning scene or something. We saw Dumbo like that, that was the first movie we saw in 4DX, and that was pretty exciting. Whenever Dumbo would fly around, you would feel like you were flying with him. So when I heard Aladdin was also available in 4DX, I was like, Aladdin plus a magic carpet flies. I think we have to see that in 4DX as well. And we did, and it was so awesome. So whenever the carpet would fly, we would of course move along. But not only with the carpet, with a lot of other stuff. Whenever they would ride over water or something like that would happen, you would feel the splashes of water. It was a very fun experience. It made it even more magical to watch it. When we came into the theater, of course, we first go to the candy store to get some snacks for during the movie. And they had this awesome popcorn bucket. Let me guys give you a closer look. So it's at the lamp and it says choose wisely. And then we have Aladdin on the side, and the lamp again, and Aladdin. It's fun that they had this because normally you don't have special popcorn buckets for movies here. I saw on the internet that, for example, with Mary Poppins, they had these upside down umbrellas where you could popcorn in up front. But we didn't have those, we just had like carton simple ones. So when I saw these, of course, I had to grab one. Now let's talk about the movie. I really loved the setting and the decor and the clothing. The clothing was amazing. Jasmine changed a lot of dresses throughout the movie, but every single one of them was so beautiful. And sometimes it was like a dress, but the dress was up, just up here, and underneath you could see that she was wearing a pants. So it was kind of like a dress, but also a pants. But all of them were very beautiful and very colorful and shiny and glittery. That's very nice. The setting of Agrabah was beautiful. It really felt authentic and was so nice with all the little markets and like the open rooftops where people would have their laundry hanging or have like a lot of pillows to sit there, or I don't know what they're there for. But it was very beautifully done. Also the castle. It wasn't the same as in the movie. It was like an animated movie with the golden pillars and everything. But it was also very, very pretty. It was the same color as the city, so it melted nicely in. But it was of course a lot bigger and extravagant, so it was very beautiful. Next thing I want to talk about was something I saw that was a major difference between this movie and the animated movie. And for me, Jasmine was already one of the more strong and independent princesses from the animated movie series. But in this movie, they went even beyond that. So they really wanted to show that strong women are in nowadays. And one example I can give you guys for that, I don't want to say too much spoilers because the story was more or less the same as the animated movie, but there were some small differences and I don't want to spoil them for you guys. So one of the main differences, for example, was in the market scene where Aladdin sings One Jump Ahead. Normally he falls into a room where they are like dancing girls around him. Now they were girls who were sitting before a school board and teaching and learning something. So that was already like a huge step towards a strong woman subject. The other one is that there was written an extra song for Jasmine, which was called Speechless. And it was about that she was no longer gonna hold it in. She was gonna speak her mind. She was gonna tell Jafar and her dad how everything is supposed to be and that she can be a good leader. And she also gave like this epic monologue at the end of the movie. So they made her even a more stronger woman. They also made a lot of references of her reading books and learning stuff about books. So that's really amazing as well. Another big change I saw in this movie, I can't talk too much about it because that's one of the spoilers, but Genie had his own extra special story in the movie, which is not in the original one. I mean, the original one, it's all about Aladdin and the Genie helping Aladdin. In this one, he had his own extra story, which I'm not gonna talk too much about it. It wasn't necessary. But it was fun. I think they did a good job including that. And there were some extra fun scenes in the movie because of that extra storyline. So, well done. Then for me, Jafar was a little bit too young to play the advisor of the Sultan. For me, he looked like he had the same age as Jasmine and Aladdin. Which is pretty young, right? I don't know. Maybe they should have taken a more older, mature man. In the movie, in the animated movie, also looks more old and more mature. In this one, for me, he looked like the same age as Aladdin, so that was kind of weird to see him like that. And also, I mean, he is the villain of the story, and he played that good. But I don't know, something was missing, like he should have been more sneaky or something, I don't know. He was villainish enough, but I missed the little sneaky part or something. Then let's move on to the singing part and the song part of the movie. That's always something that I really appreciate, good songs in the movie, and I absolutely love Alan Menken. He's such a genius in making these songs every time. And the ones in Aladdin are amazing. They're stuck in your head once you hear them in the beginning of the day. They're in your head for the rest of the day. And the problem with the movie is that you already know the voices, you already know the songs. You know how Aladdin is supposed to sound, you know how Jasmine is supposed to sound. So of course it's not easy for the actors to try and be like that because everybody already has an idea of how the character should be. But they did an okay job. I really loved Jasmine's voice. She did a very good job also in her new song Speechless. That was very amazing. She had a very beautiful, soft voice. Aladdin... I mean, I liked his voice, but sometimes I missed the energy. Like, for example, in One Jump Ahead, he sang it good, he sang it nice, but I missed the energy in the song. Same goes for Will Smith. I'm sorry. I know a lot of you guys, there was a lot of controversial about Will Smith being the genie and wanted to copy Robin Williams, which he was not planning on doing, and he didn't do that, so that's good. But his singing voice, I don't know, I sometimes felt like he was more speaking the lyrics than instead of singing it. So I'm not really sure what to say about the singing voice because it didn't really feel like a lot of singing to me. But I loved the Friend Like Me and the Prince Ali songs, the way they showed it to us. Especially the Friend Like Me in the Cave of Wonders is very beautifully done. They made a lot of references to the animated movie. But of course they can't do everything because that would look weird in an animated movie. You can roll around with your heads. That's fine, but I don't know if Will Smith would have done that in real life. I think that might have been weird, so I'm glad they didn't do that. But they find something else for it, which was really nice. It's actually one of my favorite scenes in the movie, the Friend Like Me song. They also did a very cool, awesome dance sequence with Aladdin and the genie. And Prince Ali's song for me was also very fun. They did an amazing job on that. They couldn't do it as big and as grotesque as in the animated movie because in animation, like there is no lines, there are no boundaries. You can do whatever you want. But in real life, even nowadays with the computers they have, you have to see what you do. I mean, like, they want to make it a real movie, so they cannot do as grotesque as in the animated movie, but they did an amazing job. But in this song, I also really miss the energy in Will Smith's voice. He sang this more than the Friend Like Me song. There was more singing, but I miss the energy in it. I mean, if you compare it, which I'm not supposed to do, I know that, to Robin Williams, he was much more energetic and much more, let's go, instead of Will Smith. I don't know, I was missing something in that song, and I think it was the energy. Then something I really liked is that Disney put in two little sneaky references to to their parks, actually. At one point, let me think where it was. I think it was somewhere in the first scene that we met a genie. They were just out of the Cave of Wonders, and the genie is having the conversation with Aladdin about the three wishes and what he wants and all of that stuff. And you see in the background that the magic carpet is making a sand castle. And in the beginning you see like a small castle, and all of a sudden you see this big castle, which represents one of the castles in the parks, which was really nice because it's not like out there, because it was kind of like in the background. It was very fun to watch. Another inside perk they put in there was at one point Jasmine is looking at one of her maps and she's searching for Ababwa, where Prince Ali is supposed to come from. Of course, she can't find it. So she asks him, and Aladdin asks the genie for help. So he shows up on the map and he draws a castle and he puts Fantasyland over there, which is really fun because, of course, it's not Ababwa, but it's fun that they did a reference to that in the movie. There was one thing I was really disappointed about, and I can tell you guys this because it's not a spoiler, because it was one of the trailers. I don't know if you saw that trailer, but it was a trailer where the genie and Aladdin are talking about their wishes and what the genie would wish, and Aladdin is like, can you make me a prince? And he's like, well, there's a lot of gray area in that wish, because I can do like this and you have a prince right there. What are you going to do with him? And there's an actual prince like a couple of mountains away. You can see him standing there and he's like, hello, I want to get back to my castle. And I hoped that like at the end of the movies, maybe even after the credits, because that Disney does that sometimes, but you have to wait all at the end of the credits and then they show you a couple of seconds of fun material. And I was really hoping that after the credits, which we stayed for all the way till the end, that prince would still be standing there and be like, hello, still not in my castle. But no, we waited there and the people in the cinema were already trying to clean everything up. But at least we tried. It would have been very fun if he would have showed up at the end and be like, hello, you're still here. But he didn't, so. But that was actually one of the only things I was missing in the movie. Further than that, I think Disney did an amazing job. This was actually one of my favorite live action remakes. Yeah, and I really loved all the puns they put in there. I loved the humor they had in there. There was a lot of fun scenes as well. So I really liked the movie and I really recommend to watch it. If you can, go and watch it in 4DX because that makes it even more magical. But if you're going to watch it like regularly, it will still be an amazing movie. Let me know in the comments down below what your thoughts were on the movie, if you liked it, if you didn't like it. And I will see you next time. Bye!